So dear Mrs. Anne-Claire Ampro, French Ambassador for Global Health, dear Director of One Health DG Santé European Commission, dear Member of the European Commission, dear Member of the Quadripartite Alliance, dear Professor Marie-Cécile Plouat, dear all, I am delighted to be here with you to launch this meeting of the EU GIMR 2. It has been clearly established that bacterial resistance to antibiotics or antimicrobial resistance, IMR, is a global phenomenon with no geographical or species boundaries, which pose an important threat to human health, animal, and environmental health. This phenomenon, described as a silent pandemic, is a global public health priority supported by the WHO. So the introduction of antibiotics in the clinical use are one of the greatest medical breakthroughs of the 20th century. The discovery of penicillin in 1928 marks the start of the golden age of antibiotic discovery, which reached its peak in the mid-80s. Victim of their own success, antibiotics have indeed been abusively and often inappropriately used in human as well in animals' health. This massive use of antibiotics generated a selective pressure on bacterial population, resulting in the emergence of resistant strain. For several years, the development of bacterial pathogens resistance to antibiotics has considerably complexified the treatment of deadly bacterial infection, with no therapeutic alternative in some situations. If the development of antibacterial antimicrobial resistance continues at the same level, we expect that if no action is taken, drug-resistant infection would cause several millions of deaths each year in the world by 2050. Today, it is also estimated that IMR cost in the Union amount to 1.5 billion per year in healthcare and productivity loss. Faced with this threat, states, international community, we have taken some action, and we have to recall some important steps in the European international action. Since 2017, the European Union had strategic commitment on the subject with implementation of an action plan based on the One Health principle. The European Commission is a member of the Joint Programming Initiative on Antimicrobial Resistance and has supported its strategic agenda that endorses an integrated approach of research in human, animal, environmental health, the One Health approach, to fight against this antimicrobial resistance. Today, member states, including France, support the pursuit and expansion of the GPI-IMR action through the creation in 2025 of a European partnership in the field of antimicrobial resistance, partnership One Health IMR, as part of the new Horizon Europe framework program. France, through its National Research Agency, ANR, has committed to this One Health IMR partnership by agreeing to be responsible for drawing up the strategic research and innovation programs of future partnership, as well as a roadmap and action plan. Since 2022, the W2015 Global Action Plan has been reinforced by the organization of the Quadripartite Alliance in order to implement action under the One Health approach. Briefly, the Joint Action Plan aims to stop the silent pandemic of antimicrobial resistance around two main challenges. First, optimizing the production, the use of antimicrobial through their life cycle, from research and development to disposal. And second, to reduce the incidence of human, animal, plant infection to reduce the emergence and spread of antimicrobial resistance. The recommendation of the European Council in June 2023 have highlighted again the need to reinforce both the prevention of infection and also the prudent use of antibiotics. This recommendation proposes concrete targets for reducing the use of antimicrobials by 2030, including a 20% reduction in total human consumption of antibiotics and a 50% reduction in total sales of antimicrobial use in the EU for farm animals and aquaculture. Finally, antibiotic resistance, healthcare-associated infection are also on the agenda of numerous high-level bodies such as the G7, G20, and United Nations. At the level of France, since 2016, France has been committed to operationalizing the One Health approach to controlling antibiotic resistance through the implementation of an interministerial roadmap. In addition, the recent One Health interministerial roadmap dedicated to the prevention and reduction of antibiotic resistance make it possible to reinforce the implementation and monitoring of intersectorial activity complementary to the action of prevention and reduction of antibiotic resistance already supported by sectoral plans. Besides, a number of initiatives have been launched, in particular by Santé Publique France, with the launch of the antibiotic Good Care Starts with Good Use campaign, and by INSERM through the management of priority research program on antibiotic resistance. So the program is also at the initiative of the PROMISE Meta Network, the ABRO OMIC platform, a national numeric infrastructure, and DOSA, a digital observatory of the social dimension of antimicrobial resistance. So the long-term implementation of a coordinated One Health approach remains a priority for the years to come. It is also a priority for the future. However, what is clear from the collaborative effort, it is that no state has the capacity alone to act. So it is the coordination between states is a condition for success in the global fight against antimicrobial resistance. So the primary challenge of the first EU JAMHI was the distribution and dissemination of evidence-based information, knowledge, good practices, not only in hospital and veterinary practice, but also in communities and even in family. The One Health approach, it's a One Health all policy approach, that is to say a cross-sector fight which will be initiated in all areas where microbial resistance is present. Now we are going from the first EU JAMHI to the EU JAMHI 2. INSERM, with the support of the French Ministry of Health, led the first European Union joint action on antimicrobial resistance. This first action was funded in 2017 by partners, and the EU Health Programme was a collaborative project involving 44 partners and over 40 stakeholders. The overall objective was to foster synergy across all members using a One Health approach to influence policy to tackle antimicrobial resistance and healthcare-associated infection. This project ended in 2021 after 3.5 years. It supported a range of activities, contributing to prioritizing, implementing research, innovation for public health needs, improving healthcare system, infection control capacity, and appropriate use of antimicrobial in human and animals. As you know, the results have been claimed by the EU Health Programme, and I would like to thank very much Marie-Cécile Ploy, who has brilliantly led this program, the French team, all the European partners, your success, and the recommendation and support of the European Ministry have been the asset for the European Commission to adopt the second plan. So I would like to thank the European Commission, the European partners, the Ministry of Labour, Health and Prevention for once again placing their trust in France and INSERM to lead this ambitious new program. And I thank again Marie-Cécile Ploy and her team for once again committing themselves to coordinate this new program. So this new plan will put in place policy and tools which make possible to effectively monitor, prevent, combat antibiotic resistance, to reduce the risk of exposure of European citizens to resistant bacteria by promoting surveillance and prevention, to improve the care of patients suffering from bacterial infection by guaranteeing their access to effective and proportionate antibiotic therapy, promote also the One Health approach through a close collaboration. And finally, to improve also to increase awareness, understanding of antimicrobial resistance across European member states, and produce concrete recommendations for European contribution to international initiatives. So this plan will work closely with experts from European agencies alongside global entities, including WHO, WH, OECD, UNEP, FAO, as well as representatives from industry, health and patient representatives. This plan will benefit from funding of 50 million euros by the European Commission and 12.5 million euros from European partners. It will be structured in 10 work packages, and which will be detailed during this workshop. France has the honor of coordinating this program. In addition to a dense surveillance network in France, in association with several southern countries, INSERM, INSERM Transfer, and French Ministry of Health and Agency have shown a strong coordination capacity in Europe and internationally. This capacity to mobilize, motivate, exchange will be fully committed to serving the EU-JAMRAI 2 project in full recognition of what each partner can contribute to the common effort. The major contribution expected from this joint action is in the synergy, the transparency, the consistency of multiple efforts now underway and dedicated to prevention, risk, whether viral, bacterial, or parasitic, and to give a new dimension to this health issue, make Europe a leader in this field. I would like to conclude by thanking the Ministry of Labour Health Solidarity, the staff of INSERM, as well as those of the partners of the European Union for their openness, their commitment, productive advice, and discussion which have made possible for us to put together with you a very ambitious program, but also a pragmatic and realistic project with more than 120 participants, including the ministry, public agency, hospitals, research institutes, and university. I would like to thank you very much for your attendance, and I wish you a very productive working day. Thank you very much.